guys, it's Kesara, and today I'm gonna be doing my review for Heart of Flames by Nicki Pau Preto. To Crown of Feathers, which came out last year, which I absolutely loved. I really loved Crown of Feathers, and I actually did a full review of Crown of Feathers, which I will link up in the cards for you guys if you guys want to check that out. It was one of the first reviews that I did on my channel, so please don't judge me too harshly for it, but I was so excited for Heart of Flames. You have no idea. So for those of you who don't know anything about this series follows a girl named Veronica who wants to become a phoenix rider, but phoenixes are very rare in this world and they're almost extinct, so she has to pretend to be a boy in the first book in order to join this group of phoenix riders. Heart of Flames takes place right after Crown of Feathers. Like, it takes off right where Crown of Feathers leaves off. There are also other main point of view characters that make appearances in Heart of Flames that maybe weren't as prominent characters in Crown of Feathers. So for those of you who read the first book, Veronica obviously is one of the main characters, as well as Tristan and Sev. But there are also point of view chapters for Val and Elliot as well in Heart of Flames, which made me really happy, especially Val's point of view. Like, I was really excited to get to her point of view. So like all of these videos, I'm gonna talk about four things: character, plot, world building, and writing style. And we're gonna start with character. So I absolutely love the characters in this book. Veronica and Tristan are my favorite. I love their camaraderie. I love both of their characters. They both have very interesting backstories. I think the backstories were better done in the first book than they were in the second book. Like, obviously you don't need their backstories again in the second book, but I felt like there could have been a little bit more development for them in the second book. But there was a little bit more of a relationship between them that you can really see where they start to work really well together and things like that. And I really, really enjoyed that aspect of this book. I think it worked really well and I enjoyed both of their character arcs. And then we get a few other characters, like I mentioned, that I really enjoyed as well. I have to say, Seb's point of view was not my favorite in this book. Like, I enjoyed him more in the first book. I feel like upon reread, I love Seth's point of view. Like, I feel like I will love it, but because I was so into Veronica and Tristan's point of views, every time Seth came in, I was just kind of like, no, I want to get back to Veronica and Tristan's point of views. So obviously I didn't love him as much as I wanted to, but I feel like when I reread it eventually, which will happen, trust me, it's gonna happen, I will probably love Sev. I enjoyed him and I feel like his character development is really well done, but he wasn't my favorite in this book. He always felt like a side character even though he was a main point of view character. Another character that I felt a little bit that way with was Elliot. So Elliot wasn't a big part of the first book, not very much at all. He has a bit of a character arc in this one that I did enjoy and I love the outcome of his character arc, but he was another one that I just kind of like cut him out of the book. I don't need him right now. I want to read the other characters. I feel like, again, he's potentially a character that is gonna make a bigger splash in the next book, so I'm excited to see where his character goes. He also has this kind of interesting relationship with Sparrow, if you guys remember Sparrow from the first book, and I enjoyed her as well. She reminds me, for some reason, she reminds me of Luna Lovegood. Don't ask me why, she just does, and I love her. So to the main character that I really was excited for in this book, Val. Oh my gosh, you have no idea. She is my favorite character from the first book. And you gotta know this about me, I love unlikable characters. I love it. And I love what the author tried to do with Val in this book. I absolutely love it. I loved getting things from Val's point of view. For those of you who don't know, Val is Veronica's sister who she does not have a very good relationship with. And Veronica is the main character. So obviously Val is somewhat of an antagonist and I love her perspective, like absolutely love it. I feel like I didn't get quite as bought into her perspective as I wanted to. Like, I wanted to love her more than I did and I didn't quite get there. Like, I actually started not liking her in book two, even though I loved her in book one. And mind you, I love her because she's unlikable. Even though she has some point of views and all of that in book two, I felt like some of her things just didn't really add up that well in book two, that didn't really work for me as well as it did in book one, but I did really, really enjoy her even so. Next, we're gonna talk about plot. And I have to say, this book was a lot more ambitious than the first book was. It tries to do a lot more things in a more interesting way, and the politics are definitely more intricate in this book than it was in the first book. Mind you, this book is also significantly longer than the first book was, so there's a lot more going on in this book than there was in the first book. And I have to say, the plot didn't fully work for me. there was a lot of things about just the timeline and things that didn't really work out for me, especially when it came to Sev and Val's point of view. I felt like both of their plot lines should have meshed a little bit better, and it didn't quite work out for me the way the timeline works, because some of the motivations, not of Sev and Val specifically, but of some of the other side characters, didn't really work with where some of the plot points were. So I felt like there was some fleshing out need to be done with the plot structure, but overall I did really enjoy the plot, especially, like I said, Veronica and Tristan's plot. Absolutely love their plot, and really excited to see where the series is going in the next book. I will have to say, I think the ending of Crown of Feathers was significantly better than the ending of Heart of Flames, like significantly better, but I still really, really enjoyed this one. And of course, the next thing we have to talk about is world building, and I loved the world building, like absolutely love the world building in this series. The world building is fantastic. I love all of the lore and the history behind the Phoenix Riders and their previous war, and just like everything. Everything is so good. I love the map that they have in this book. I have to give a shout out to the map. The map is gorgeous. Absolutely love it. I love like the different cultures that they have. They don't go super into detail with the cultures in this book, but I like just a little glimpse of the different cultures that we get. I enjoy that. And I love it. I love everything about the world building in this book. Like, it's done so well. I'm never pulled out of the story because of things that don't make sense or anything like that. I love every second of the world building, and that's half the reason why I love this series. And last but not least, we have to talk about writing style. I didn't really have any major call-outs when it came to the writing style of this book. It felt very much like the first one. It's pretty fast paced. I didn't feel like there were any like major info dumps, even though the author did a really good job of giving all the information we needed when we needed it. I also really love it when before each chapter, like there's this little thing before each chapter, but there's also like a document that is like a historical document. I love getting all of those things. So I love that aspect of the writing style as well. And I just enjoy reading from this author. This author is a great writer and I really enjoy reading her books. So I don't really wanna go into spoilers with this one. I don't have a whole lot to say that is not spoiler free, but let me know down in the comments if you've read this book, because I would love to discuss it with guys. Like seriously, this is like one of my favorite series that is currently coming out and I really enjoy it. But that's all I have for you guys today. I post videos every Monday, Thursday, and Saturday at 6 p.m. Eastern time, so consider subscribing. I also post bonus videos. If you wanna be notified as soon as I upload, you can click that little bell icon. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up to support my channel. All social media links are in the description down below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.